Hello, I'm Fabio Fussi from UNICEF, and I'm presenting in this module the activity of mapping and identification of favorable zone for manual drilling. In this module, we'll see the following topics: the explanation of the type of information, methodology, and results that we have achieved in 12 countries where we have already completed the mapping of suitable zone at country level for manual drilling; the recommendation for the use of the maps and mapping reports that we have produced in order to plan manual drilling development, and next steps for detailed studies that will follow afterwards; and the indication for management of the geographic database and its use in other type of application that was one of the results in the first phase. The goal of the mapping study were different. From one side, there was the identification of the favorable zone at country level, where geological and environmental conditions are suitable for manual drilling. The second one is the definition of zones having highest priority for the implementation of manual drilling, crossing the technical feasibility map of manual drilling with the data about the population and present drinking water coverage and other aspects that can be considered relevant in each country to define the decision regarding the implementation of manual drilling. And the third one is the setting up a national geographic database, starting from the information available but not well organized. We must be aware that in the first phase of this study, we work at country level, so the results that we achieved, they are considered a first step to define regional areas where manual drilling are feasible, but a second step of detailed location has to be followed afterwards. Mapping has been completed in 12 countries. As we have seen, most of them they are in Western Africa, part in Central Africa and Madagascar. There is a common methodology, but in each country we have adapted the common methodology to the specific condition in terms of environment, geology, and type of information available. The general methodology has been based in the integration of different sources of information and a continuous collaboration between a GIS team of experts, geographic information system experts, and local geologists and water supply technicians. Three categories of data were used: numeric data available in internet and public available, numeric data available in the country and that were provided by the different institutions, and the local experience not systematized by the local technician, local geologist, local water technician, and people involved in the local management of water resources. The integration of the two sets of numeric data, the one provided by the institution and the one available in the internet, allowed through a common integration and standardization to create a geographic database. Processing and interpretation of this database with the continuous feedback from the local experience technician has allowed to create the map of suitable zones. In this case, it is really important to understand how we tried to transform in geographic layers the stories, the not systematized experience, and the not well organized data that were available in the different technicians. Suitability to manual drilling is determined on the basis of three main parameters: the geological suitability, the water depth suitability, and geomorphological suitability. Let's explain. The geological suitability is basically the presence in the first 30 or 40 meters of unconsolidated sediments or soft rocks or weathered layers that can be drilled easily with manual drilling techniques. The water depth suitability, it means the presence in the first 20 or 30 meters of exploitable water that can be achieved that depth with the manual drilling techniques. The geomorphological suitability, it means the presence of morphology in the surface that facilitate the accumulation of unconsolidated sediment and the shallow groundwater close to the surface. These three parameters were analyzed together for all the techniques of manual drilling, although we know that the different techniques that can be applied can have more or less dependent from one or the other parameter. For example, there are techniques like the percussion techniques that can be used in slightly hard layers, while other techniques like jetting can absolutely not be used in that formation. So we made a common analysis, we established a common suitability, but then we give a specific recommendation of this type of techniques can be used in the different zones. So the cross analysis of these three parameters, we determine the suitability to manual drilling, like a parameter that establishes in each zone the degree of feasibility of manual drilling in that area. To estimate the geological suitability, we use three main sources of information. The geological map, that in general was available at a regional or national level, not very well detailed. That was the basic information, plus the existing geological studies, the borehole logs, and the database of water points that were available in each country. With a procedure based in different automatic processing of the data, we simplified the geological map. We described each geological formation under a set of parameters defined by the experience of the local geologist. We reclassified the geological map, and where we arrived to the map of geological suitability. Here we can see an example. We have the geological map of Central African Republic. Reclassifying this map using the attribute table created by the local geologist, we transform the geological map in a chart, in a map of geological suitability. The different geological formation has been reclassified in terms of higher or lower suitability to manual drilling. To estimate the water depth suitability, we used as a source of information mainly the database of water points, plus the existing hydrogeological studies and the climatic and environmental data and studies available in the country. In this case, without entering details in the automatic procedure, we made a combination of automatic processing and direct interpretation of the data, integrated with the qualitative information coming from the studies, and we arrived to the map of water depth suitability. Here we can also see an example. We have the map with all the water points of Senegal. They were visualized according to the different level of static water level of the water. In red, deeper than 25 meters, in green, between 15 and 25 meters, and in blue, where the water table was less than 15 meters deep. With a direct and visual interpretation of the distribution of the water points, we arrived to the estimation of the expected water depth in each region. As we can see here, there are two types of information here. Not only there is the expected depth of water depth, but according to the density and the homogeneous trend of the water points in the original data, we establish what we call the level of information. It means in some area, we establish that the information that we had was sufficient to have a reliable interpretation. In some other area, we gave an interpretation, but we fixed in the maps that the level of information was not enough to be sure of our interpretation, and we recommend a better details and better verification in the field once we are going to the second step. The geomorphological suitability refers to the presence of surface layers generally not recorded in the geological maps, but they are composed by unconsolidated sediment or weathered layers that are not the same characteristics of the main geological formation, but on the surface, in the first 20 or 30 meters, we have a suitable condition for manual drilling, even if we are on top of hard rock. Therefore, the geomorphological suitability is important to integrate the information coming from the geology with some other information referring to the surface layers. It was really difficult to find any geomorphological information in this country. Geomorphological information or geomorphological maps, it means maps with more information on the surface deposits and surface morphology and less in the deep ground geology. Then the main source of information in this case has been the digital elevation model. It means a map with, for each zone, the elevation above sea level. This elevation model is public available in internet for all over the world. We downloaded from internet the digital elevation model for each country, and we integrated with their interpretation from the geomorphological studies and maps existing where these were available. And we basically, with automatic procedure of analysis, we divided in different geomorphological parameters. The slope position, it means if an area was recognized is in the top of the hill, in the bottom of the valley, or in an intermediate position. And comparing the slope and the slope position, we obtain the morphological map. It means a map in which each area has been given the type of shape, morphology on the surface. Imagining that there is a relation between the surface morphology with the type of deposit that we can have it, and particularly imagining that in the bottom of the valley, we have the highest potential for manual drilling because there are accumulation and consolidated sediments. From this, we obtain the map of geomorphological suitability. Here is an example of starting from the digital elevation model that we downloaded from internet. With different automatic procedure, we obtain the slope position at different degree of resolution, and through all this procedure, we obtain the geomorphological unit maps. The final results of the cross-analysis of geological suitability, water depth suitability, and geomorphological suitability is the final map of general suitability for manual drilling. In this map, we can recognize different colors corresponding to different categories of suitability to manual drilling. In red is the lowest suitability, in blue is the highest suitability. This type of map can be used to define in which region it's worth to go on with more detailed analysis, because there is a good potential that manual drilling can represent a good solution for water supply in that area. But apart from the environmental interpretation, we can use the map of general suitability compared with other type of information to define priority for the implementation of the manual drilling program. For example, here we are comparing the map of suitable zone of Sierra Leone with the distribution of population and the water coverage in Sierra Leone. Here we have seen that we have in blue the most suitable area, and here we have in red the area with the lowest water drinking water coverage. If we make a cross analysis of these two maps, we can, for example, define area where we have more than 75% of people without drinking water, and in the meantime, we have very good suitability. In this case, we can identify that this area can be a suitable area where we can plan geographic location for manual drilling implementation. In that area, we can define the highest priority. How can we go from the country level of analysis that we've done in our study and the identification of favorable zones to the more detailed level that is necessary to implement the manual drilling and identify exactly the location of the wells? Some layer of information that we have in our database are not detailed enough. For example, in general, the geological map is not detailed, but some others, like the digital terrain model or the water point database, in general, they are sufficient enough level of details to allow for more detailed analysis. As we can see here in Senegal, we have the distribution of the older water points that allow to have the national map of water depth suitability. But we can zoom in a specific area, plot on top of an aerial picture or an existing topographic map, and having some indication that will allow in the field to have a more close idea of what is going on close or far from the Senegal River. So the level of detail for some type of information is already sufficient for more detailed analysis. In some other case, we give specific recommendation how to integrate the information available in the geographic database with more detailed information. Therefore, the geographic database is useful not only for our study and for the detailed analysis of the location of manual drills, but can be also used for other type of application, natural resource management and conservation, agriculture, water supply, infrastructure and transport, demography, health, and other type of analysis that can be carried out. The geographic information is useful in different steps of the program, for the identification and planning of action, for the monitoring of the activities carried out during a program, and for the evaluation of the impacts on how our program or other programs modify the situation at the end of the project. As we have seen, the geographic database is an important product of results obtained in the first phase and can be used for different applications. But it is important that to be a good tool for geographic analysis is well managed and integrated with other information. In particular, there are some recommendations. We have to go on with the data collection, integrating other layers of data that were not collected during the first phase. It is important that any other information included in the database is confirmed in terms of the quality, and it is ensured that it is consistent with the other layers already existing. And it's really, really important that information is continuously updated. The geographic database is a dynamic tool. If we imagine data regarding population or existing wells, it is clear that to have a correct picture of the situation, we have continually to update this information. All the operations on the geographic database can be done with different GIS software, including free of cost and open source packages that can be downloaded from the web. Thank you.